All right, guys, it is Saturday night, and it is officially the beginning of the stretch of Halloween slash spooky slash scary slash horror movies. Now, I will say right off the bat, you want to use discretion about these movies that I'm going to be talking about, because usually this channel is very family friendly, but when you get into Halloween and spooky and scary and horror, it's not really for kids. There are plenty of options for kids, though. So just because I'm talking about one kind of movie for the night that I'm going to be watching doesn't mean that that's what you have to watch. I started out with a different idea when I went shopping for our snack this week. But while I was there, I got an inkling and I came up with another idea. Tonight, I am going to be watching Children of the Corn. Stephen King's Children of the Corn, the original. I absolutely love this movie, guys. I've even been to the town where they filmed it.
This is my number one bucket list horror movie filming location of all time. Right now, I am in Gatlin, Nebraska, which is actually Whiting, Iowa. And if you guys don't recognize this, this is the middle of town where Children of the Corn was filmed. Look at this. This is absolutely amazing to me. I mean, it basically looks like a completely abandoned town. So being here right now looks and feels exactly how it feels to watch Children of the Corn. That movie has played such a part in my life, in loving everything spooky and loving just horror movies as a whole. I mean, my entire life, anytime I have ever seen corn, I have thought of Children of the Corn. So there goes a car right now through town. There's another one over here. There was actually a motorcycle that drove through and a few other things. You can see some other cars up here. So this is a fully functional town, despite the way that it looks. And we are actually going to go in this Good Time Charlie's and get a malt before we leave. But I want to show you a few things from around here first. Now, I will tell you first, if you've never seen Children of the Corn from 1984, it is scary, it is bloody, it is awesome, and it happened right here. At the beginning of the movie, Joby and his dad go in this malt shop right across the street. It's called Hanson's. Now, you don't see the exterior until later on in the movie, but you can recognize it with this over here.
Hanson's Cafe.
And look at this. This absolutely blows me away. Up here is still the malts and sodas sign. I can't believe that. I don't know if this is actually a functional business right now. It looks like it's maybe like a thrift store or something. But in the movie, the interiors were not shot at this location. This was just used for the exterior. And if you've watched my movie filming locations videos before, you know that a lot of movies are filmed like in different locations and then stitched together to make it look like one single place. So yeah, in the movie, this was used as the exterior shots of Hanson's. In the interior shots where you see Isaac walk up to the window, those were actually filmed like 10 miles away in another town called Hornick. The exterior of that one actually looked more like this, with the two windows and one door. And as Isaac is supposedly standing at this window right here in front of this malt shop, you can see the United States Post Office behind him, which you can clearly see here in Whiting is beside the malt shop. But in Hornick, he would be standing at like this window, and right behind him, you could see the post office. So I gotta point this out too, guys. It's really spooky to see stuff like this. These paintings, the religious things around town here. And then like over here on this window, there's a Bible passage, John 14:6. Because Children of the Corn is based on like basically religion gone wrong. All the adults in the movie have been killed. The kids have all taken over and they basically kill any other adults that come into town. So I only have a little bit of time here in town. I gotta hit the road, but I wanted to show you this as well because this is like probably the most iconic spot in the entire movie. If I had my drone out, you could see this better, but if you look at the shape of these buildings over here, the light poles, and then heading down this way to the flagpole in the middle of the street, and this building back here. This area is the middle of town. This is where Malachi was coming down through town, leading all the other children of the corn. And he had Vicky, and he was yelling, "Outlander!" And then he went to the middle of town to that flagpole right there. And from this angle right here, he's standing at the flagpole. He's holding Vicky, and he's saying, "Outlander, maybe you don't hear so well." And he cuts her face and she screams. And I'll tell you what, guys, being here right now on location in the middle of town where that happened is absolutely unbelievable. If you have never been to an actual movie filming location from a movie that you love, you've got to do it at some point. Like, you know it's just a movie, but stepping out into a real town, into a place where it was filmed, and this town is fully functional, it just feels like it makes the whole thing real. You just feel like, oh my God, this is really where it happened. Even though you know it never really did happen. And to come over here and like touch this flagpole right now, this is absolutely amazing to me. If I had more time and more daylight, I would make the whole video today. I would love to see each and every one of the locations where they filmed that movie. But from now on, every single time I watch Children of the Corn, it will have a completely different feeling because I've actually been where it happened. Outlander, we have your woman! Outlander, maybe you don't hear so well!
So to kick off this awesome season of Halloween, we are going to be making a snack tonight that is very Halloween-y and fall-y and delicious. I'm talking about Children of the Corn Chex Mix. I know. Come with me. We're going to go to Walmart and get everything we need. Then we're going to come back here and make the snack. And then we can disperse and watch our spooky movies.
Holy crap, guys, check this out. Very soon we're gonna be making the Rice Krispie Treat Monsters. But look at this. As I walk in the door, I see these delicious chocolatey peanut butter Rice Krispie Treats. Oh my gosh, those look absolutely delicious. What we are in search of right now is awesome, delicious tastiness to make a delicious fall mix. Like almost like a Chex Mix. They're just now beginning to put out some Halloween stuff. This is not Halloween, but the reason why I wanted to start in this section is because of things like this. Look at this, M&M's pumpkin pie flavor. I don't know how that would go over, but the colors of those would be perfect for our mix. We're gonna put them on hold for the moment. Look at this, we got the Ghouls blend here, which is basically the same colors as regular M&M's. So look at these. These are a new Snuggie product. It's 2-in-1 pillow and snack tray. This one looks like Cheetos. This one looks like Pepsi. But if we flip this around and open it up, which I'm not going to do that one, but I'll show you this, it looks like this. It's got a place to put drinks and a snack bowl. I don't know, that's kind of cool. All right, I'm hoping they have some more Halloween themed or colored M&M's down this aisle here somewhere. But let's come down the cereal aisle first and just kind of look at what kind of cereals we could use for our snack mix. We want something that has kind of like fall colors in it. Now usually you use Chex, but you don't have to. You can use Crispix down here. We can use the generic rice squares. And these are definitely cheaper by a couple dollars. These are $2.98, like for the oat crunch, cinnamon oat crunch. We got corn squares, rice squares. And if we come up here, to like the same size of rice and corn checks, they're at least a dollar more. Here's wheat checks, honey nut checks. They're all basically the same thing, and for what we're using them for, it's not even gonna matter. If there's a difference, I would just say that probably the actual General Mills checks would stay crunchier in milk longer. But we're not putting them in milk, so it doesn't matter. The cheap ones would work. You could even use Life cereal, and Life cereal is absolutely delicious. Before we decide on that, though, I want to take a walk down through here and see if they happen to have any Halloween cereals out yet. Man, guys, I am a cereal lover, and this whole aisle here is like heaven to me. Look at this. We got Cookie Crisp down there. You could use those if you want to. We even got Reese Puffs here. And look at this, Kit Kat cereal. Kit Kat cereal would definitely be a good thing, because how many times do you get Kit Kats when you go trick-or-treating? Look at this. These would also be perfect. The Cinnamon Toast Crunch and the Cocoa Puffs. And look, they even have birthday cake loaded. These are all delicious. We actually used these when we made those Muddy Buddies one time. I think we made those for the Scooby-Doo movie night, and we called them Puppy Chow. They were delicious. All right, no Halloween cereals in that aisle, but sometimes they have a setup down here, and that's a negative today. Look at this, they have the Halloween Boo Oreos with the orange cream. On the hunt for Halloween cereals, and I am not seeing any yet. Well, kind of surprising, but I don't see any in here yet. Some people might think it's too early for that, but Walmart is usually pretty quick to get these things out. Oh, look at this. We got the awesome, spooky-looking jack-o'-lantern sugar cookies. I can taste those just looking at them. We do have some candy corn down here hiding in the corner, but you don't really want to put candy corn in a cereal mix. All right, let's head back down our cereal aisle here and make a choice. You know what, I think we're gonna go ahead and go with the Corn Chex for Children of the Corn Chex Mix. All right, let's go ahead down this aisle, see if we can find some candy and stuff to mix in. All right, I guess they don't have any candy in this aisle, but they do have nuts. Maybe we should get some peanuts. Wait a minute, forget the peanuts. Here we got Corn Nuts. So I've never had Corn Nuts. We're gonna try them. I really don't know how hard they are, but I'll try some before I mix them in. We don't want anybody breaking teeth. Look at this. I saw the Jif peanut butter logo here, and I was like, oh, maybe some of these. They're milk bones for dogs. Oh my gosh, look at this, guys. Mini Harvest Handfuls by Cadbury. They're like Cadbury mini eggs, but they're colored like fall. These are kind of hard to chew though, and I think they're a little too big to put in a mix. Where in the world did they put all the candy? They're moving in like school supplies and stuff over here, and the candy is nowhere to be found. Usually it's all over here or in the grocery section, and I don't see it anywhere. So we're back to the pumpkin pie M&Ms for a minute here. I really want regular M&Ms. I honestly don't think pumpkin pie flavor is going to be very good. All right, here it is, A7. I completely walked by it, and maybe it's because it doesn't say candy up there. All right, so now we can get kind of creative here. There's really only like two or three other things that I want to put in here. One of them is those M&Ms, and I would prefer to find the fall-colored M&Ms, but I don't know if that's going to happen. This is their selection of M&Ms here, aside from just like the theater candy boxes. This is classic M&Ms. Those are the regular colors. We got peanut butter M&Ms, but again, those are all different colors. It looks like no matter what kind we choose here, we're gonna get all the regular colors, so. All right, I'm gonna settle on the regular M&Ms, and it is cheaper to get three boxes of these than the smallest bag they have over there. What the heck is going on, man? I want chocolate-covered pretzels, and this is all I'm finding, yogurt-covered pretzels. I do not want those. Let's see if we can find some up here somewhere, just like a small bag of chocolate-covered pretzels. What the heck, man? Here's white ones again. Here's Reese dipped pretzels. those might be good, but I really am not thinking about the peanut butter taste tonight. Or else I would go ahead and just put Reese Pieces in there. I mean, worst case scenario, I can just get a bag of regular pretzels and kind of break them up into smaller pieces, but I really wanted all the pieces to be completely covered with chocolate, so every bite is chocolatey pretzel goodness. All right, let's get out of here. I'm gonna go over and check the Dollar Tree for the pretzels, and if they don't have them, we'll do without. And I knew I should have just come over here to the Dollar Tree to make this mix. Look at this. They got the exact same corn nuts I just bought at Walmart. And they got the M&Ms. And surprise, surprise, they have a ton of chocolate-covered pretzels. Looks like for the cereal, we would have had to go with something like Cheerios, Honey Nut Cheerios, Cinnamon Toast Crunch, even Lucky Charms, but that's not very Halloween-y. I am gonna grab a couple of these Snapple apples, though.
Okay, so let's take a look at everything that we just picked up between the Dollar Tree and Walmart. So while I was in the Dollar Tree, I went ahead and got a clear bowl so you can see better when I'm mixing it. I gotta wash that. I got a couple of smaller clear bowls that we can put them in, more of like a serving size when we're done. I got two bags of the chocolate-covered pretzels, and I went ahead and bought one bag of peanuts, just in case the corn nuts don't work. Because I've never eaten those before, I don't know how hard and crunchy they are, and maybe they just wouldn't taste right in here anyway. But at Walmart, we got the box of Corn Chex, we got the bag of corn nuts, and we got three boxes of M&Ms. I really wish we would have been able to find like the fall color M&Ms that are just regular chocolate. I really didn't feel good about trying those pumpkin flavored ones. That stuff never really tastes right. So give me a minute to wash these up, and then we're gonna mix this all up and make our delicious Children of the Corn Chex mix. Okay, we got that cleaned up. We got everything ready to roll. I will tell you, these bowls are definitely one-time use. It already split just from me washing it, but it'll serve the purpose for now. I wanted you guys to be able to see clearly while we mix this stuff up. It's just more fun. So we are gonna start with our Chex mix right here, and we are just gonna go ahead and pour it all in. Now I am gonna move this out of the way for a minute and use this just to mix up our smaller things. So we're gonna start with our M&Ms, and we're gonna pour them all in there. I think regardless of whether the corn nuts work out or not, I do want peanuts in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and pour those in. Go ahead and mix those up a little bit. That smells amazing already. Next, we know we definitely want the milk chocolate covered pretzels in there. We're gonna take these and just kind of break them up in there so that they're in smaller pieces, because you don't want full-size pretzels in there. You wanna be able to dig your hand in and just grab a handful of everything, the entire mix. Get a little taste of everything in every bite. All right, there we go, that's pretty good. And now the corn nuts. I've never tasted them before. I don't know how hard they are. I don't know if the flavor of these is even gonna meld right in this kind of mix. So let's go ahead and get these open and give them a little taste test. That's what it looks like right there. Just actual kernels of corn that are dried. All right, let's give them a taste. I will say this, they are pretty dang good, but they also are kind of what I expected. They're a little bit harder to bite through than anything else that's gonna be in this mix. They definitely would add another taste and texture in there, and they would be delicious. So if you wanna put these in yours, you can, but I think I'm just gonna set them aside for now and not use them. They're good, but I think this stuff will be better without it this time. Let's bring our big bowl back over here. I'm actually gonna add another bowl to this mix, and we are gonna go half and half. So pour about that much in there. That way we can have two bowls going where we kind of pour them back and forth and mix them up really good. Go ahead and mix this up a little bit. Something like that. It's falling all over the place. Didn't exactly work out how I thought it would. But in the end, it's all going in the same bowl. Okay, so the last thing we need to do is give it its real flavor. We got everything mixed together here in the bowl. The next thing we need to do is mix together a couple of simple ingredients here to give it the real flavor. Now, you guys don't have to do this. If you're happy with it as it is, that is perfectly fine. Because these ingredients do sound kind of strange, but believe me, it is delicious when it's done. So, we've got some butter here. We have some Worcestershire sauce, onion powder, seasoning salt, and garlic powder. Now, I'm going to put the recipe for this down below in the description. We used an entire box of Chex cereal, so I'm going to modify this a little bit. You're going to want to modify it using this recipe. So we melt our butter first, then we mix in all of our seasonings. Mix that up good. Worcestershire sauce, however you say it. Get that mixed up really good, and then we're going to pour this over top and mix it in. And to make sure that gets mixed in good, we're going to pull out our other bowl again. Put about half of it in there and just pour it right over top and just start mixing it up. After you've done that, you can put them in Ziploc bags because you're going to be storing some of it anyway. And then this is just a better way to get them coated with that mixture. And there you go, you got two big bags of Chex Mix. And then we use our smaller bowls and just kind of portion them out. I'm just gonna pour a little bit in here. Rest you can put in the other bag. Zip it up and save it for later. And there you go, guys. Children of the Corn Chex Mix. Smells delicious. Just get a little handful here. Oh, that is so good. The perfect snack for an awesome fall Halloween movie night.